Hi and welcome to my YouTube channel and the wonderful world of Atari 8-bit devices. Here I have Atari 600XL microcomputer for home use. It was released in 1983, so in this video we're gonna do an unboxing of almost 40 years old computer. We're gonna have a look at the technical specifications and we will enjoy playing some old computer games with a do-it-yourself joystick thanks to the sponsor of this video, PCBWay.com. PCBWay is a well-known company for printed circuit board manufacturing. They also offer assembly, 3D printing and CNC services. PCBWay maintains a shared directory with a lot of cool projects. Basically, users upload Gerber files so other people can directly order them. And this is exactly how I got the printed circuit board for the do-it-yourself joystick used in this video. Thanks to C64 Istanbul for designing and uploading this printed circuit board in the shared directory of PCBWay. It is compatible with Commodore, Atari and Amiga, which all use 9-pin game controllers. I'm going to do an unboxing, although obviously this is not a brand new item. I've purchased the Atari 600XL as a used item on the second-hand market. The original cardboard box is missing, but the styrofoam packaging is here. Although this computer is definitely not in a mint condition, it is well preserved. So here is what we have in the box of Atari 600XL. Obviously we have the computer, a big power supply, a cable to connect the computer to a TV, and a couple of games. One of the games is provided as a cassette and the other one as a cartridge. This huge bulky adapter converts main voltage to 5 volts running with direct current up to 1.8 amperes. Nowadays most of the USB devices run at 5 volts, including your smartphone, and you can notice the difference between the charger of your smartphone and this huge AC-DC adapter that is provided with Atari 600XL, but this is what it used to be almost 40 years ago. Atari 600XL was provided with an antenna cable so that users can directly hook it to their TV sets. This was a typical way to enjoy a personal computer in the late 70s and 80s because external monitors were quite expensive. The package also includes a couple of games. The first one is provided on a cassette and it's called Desmond Dungeons. It's for any Atari, but basically you need a cassette player that should be connected to your Atari computer to enjoy this game. On the back of the package of the cassette, we read that Desmond's Dungeon requires a joystick control and only 60K of RAM, which is perfect for Atari 600XL because this is the exact amount that we have on this computer. Back then, cassettes were very cheap. Unfortunately, the disadvantage is that you have to wait quite some time to load the game. And the best and most common way to enjoy a good game on Atari device, no matter if it's a computer or a TV console, was a cartridge. And here we have Pac-Man on Atari cartridge with the brand Atari Home Computers. It states that it's made in the United States of America in 1983 by Atari, all rights are reserved, and back then, Atari was a Warner Communications company. Unlike the cartridge, the computer that I have here was made in Hong Kong. On the top of the computer, we have the socket where the cartridge should be inserted in order to play games. The Atari XL line of computers, including this Atari 600XL, had really nice keyboards for that time, especially compared to Sinclair Spectrum alternatives. On the back, we can see the serial number as well as a label that is compatible with TV sets for PAL. With this video, I'm opening a brand new chapter in the modest history of my YouTube channel. From now on, from time to time, I'll be making videos about retro electronics, old computers like this one, portable devices, and even mobile devices. This Atari
600XL is older than me. In my childhood, I haven't used it. I've purchased this used item on a second-hand market a few years ago, so I'm a little bit nervous. Please don't judge me too harsh and leave a comment below what type of content would you like to see and if I'm missing anything important about this computer.
Initially, Atari 600XL was available on the market for $550. However, the price later on was reduced dramatically. Atari 600XL comes with MOS technology 6502C 8-bit CPU running at frequency of 1.79 MHz for NTSC users and 1.77 MHz for PAL users. This Atari features 24 kilobytes ROM memory, this is the read-only memory, out of which 16 kilobytes are for the operating system and 4 kilobytes are for the basic interpreter. Atari 600XL has just 16 kilobytes of RAM memory, however, it's expandable to 64K. From technical point of view, there are two separate keyboards. The main keyboard is for typing, and on the right side of Atari 600XL, we have a secondary keyboard with reset, options, select, start, and help buttons. On the bottom of this keyboard, there is also a power LED to indicate when the computer is turned on. Most of the connectors are on the rear side of Atari 600XL. Looking from left to right, we have a port for attaching peripheral devices such as floppy drives, disk drives, cassette players, printers, and so on. This is the so-called Atari SIO port, which stands for Serial Input Output, and was a proprietary peripheral bus for Atari 8-bit devices. This connector features 13 male pins and is actually very useful and interesting for do-it-yourself projects to extend the features of your Atari. Next, there is a phono jack for connecting the computer to a TV. This connector provides analog signal and was the regular way how to connect your computer to a TV because back then monitors were quite expensive. The lucky users back then with an appropriate monitor were able to attach it to the computer with the 5-DIN connector labeled as monitor. On the rear side of the computer, we can also find the power in connector, which is using the DIN 7 standard, and this is where we have to plug in the bulky power adapter in order to turn on the computer. Last but not least, on the very far right on the rear side of Atari 600XL, we have a switch to turn on and off the computer. On the right side of Atari 600XL, there are a couple of connectors for attaching joysticks. Officially, there are known as controller port 1 and controller port 2. Both ports are identical, they're using the 9-pin D-sub connector, which allows you to connect two joysticks and have multiplayer on this device. Earlier versions of Atari, like the Atari 400 and 800, featured 4 ports. However, for the XL series, like 600XL and 800XL, the ports were reduced to only 2. Atari 600XL is smaller than 800XL and is quite compact. The 600XL comes with dimensions of 37.5 cm by 22 cm by 6 cm height. The funny thing is that unlike the computer, the power supply is very bulky and it's hard to carry it on. It's approximately 20 by 10 cm. Atari 600XL weighs approximately 2 kilograms, actually a little bit less than that, and the power supply is 1.5 kilograms.
Let me tell you a little bit of history. Atari is well known as a brand for playing games, but in 1979 they've entered the market for personal computers, which actually back then were called just microcomputers. So in 1979, Atari released the 8-bit Atari 400 and Atari 800. 4 years later, in 1983, Atari released this Atari 600XL and Atari 800XL, which unlike the 600XL, comes with more RAM memory. 2 years later, there was another reincarnation of the 8-bit computers by Atari. In 1985, they released the XE series, like this rare Atari 800XE. We're gonna feature it in another video. The support of Atari 8-bit computers was officially stopped in 1992, 30 years ago.
Let's get it started and have some fun with this Atari 600XL. Before turning it on, we need to do a little bit of wiring. I'm going to use the antenna cable to connect it to my TV. The second thing that I need to connect, actually the most important, is the power supply, which goes in the dedicated power in connector on the rear side of Atari 600XL. Of course, computers like this Atari are mainly used for playing games, and we'll need an appropriate controller for this. At the beginning of the video, I've mentioned about the shared directory of the sponsor of this video, PCBWay.com. I have already ordered a blue PCB with an appropriate controller for Commodore 64, Amiga, and of course, Atari 8-bit devices. I've purchased some additional components in order to assemble it. There are 4 small keys, as well as 2 a little bit larger. All of the components are through-hole. Probably the most important is the DB9 connector and an appropriate cable with which I'm gonna connect this do-it-yourself controller to the computer. As part of my preparation for this video, I have already soldered all these components on the printed circuit board from PCBWay, so now all I need to do is to just connect it to port 1 on the side of the Atari 600XL. The second step to get some video output from this computer using the antenna cable is to plug it into the RF input connector on the back of my TV. As of 2022, it's still possible to buy TVs with such an antenna analog input on the European market, and actually I've purchased this LG TV earlier this year. Now, using the remote control, let's turn it on and switch the source to live TV. Please note that before recording this video, I have already gone through the procedure for finding the analog channel from the settings of the TV. And finally, I'm ready to turn on my gorgeous Atari 600XL. The red LED on the right side of the computer will turn on. On the TV, we can see and hear that the computer is ready and we can write applications in BASIC. I'm pretty sure that back in the 80s, parents were buying computers like this Atari 600XL, expecting that their children will learn how to use BASIC and get ready for all the new jobs that the IT industry is going to create in the next decade. But let's be honest, most of the children were primarily interested in playing games, and this is exactly what I'm going to do right now. As you have seen during the unboxing of this computer, I have a cartridge with a very popular game called Pac-Man. I have to carefully insert the cartridge into the computer and after that press the start button to launch a game for a single player. Pac-Man is one of these games that supported the old school multiplayer. Well, actually it was not exactly a multiplayer, but more like 2 players using the same computer and the same TV, with 2 different controllers. There is an option at the beginning of the game to select 2 players. Well, it's really hard for me to admit it, but I have never been particularly good at any games. So now, using the magic of the video editing, let's at least get to the next level of this legendary Pac-Man game.
Thank you for watching this video. I hope you've all enjoyed it and learned some interesting facts about Atari 600XL 8-bit microcomputer released in 1983. If you had a similar computer, please leave a comment below. What was your experience with the 8-bit computers by Atari? Which were your favorite games? What kind of applications did you develop for them? Thank you very much for watching. Please stay tuned for new videos. And if you like this type of content, please hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. See you soon!